talked about the different design elements, point, structure, line, focus, things like that. The last thing to talk about before we start talking about the nuts and bolts of what needs to be included in a theatrical design is let's take a quick second and talk about the different types of sets. There are three major types that we are going to be concerned with here. So the first type of set that I want you to familiarize yourself with is called a box set. This is a realistic depiction of a room on the stage. A box set is used in shows where you have one primary location. So wherever that location is, you tend to box it in. It gets its name because this is a set that is usually used in proscenium theaters. So the back walls of the set form the three sides of the box, with the opening where the audience can view in serving as the invisible fourth wall, hence the term. A box set does not necessarily have to be uber realistic, but in most cases it is. The next type of set I want you to know about is called a unit set. This is a generic multi-purpose setting that endeavors to function as a number of different locations without physical changes in the set itself. This is the type of set that's very popular with modern-day Shakespearean performances. It's hodgepodge of different shapes and sizes. As you can see from this example, multiple levels, but nothing distinctive to any one location or time period. Now, what we're looking at here is a white model. This is not the actual set. So we have no idea what color this set has been painted, if it's been given any kind of texturing to make it look modern or to make it look from a time period or to give it a more organic look. But as you can see, especially with the various acting spaces provided with the unit set, you can create a number of different locations simply by where the action is taking place. So usually the only things that come on and off to help differentiate different locations or scenes are the pieces of furniture and possibly the lights. Last up, we have a multiple set, and this is kind of the exact opposite of the unit set. This is when you have moving stages, moving elements, moving set pieces that shift on and off to represent different locations. So as opposed to just having one blanket, uniform playing space, the multi-set actually transforms depending on where you are and what is happening in the scene. So as you can imagine, there are different design questions that need to be answered when you're working with a multi-set. Things like, where are you going to store the excess pieces when they're not on stage? How are you going to get them on and off? Things of that nature. So multiple sets are very popular in musical performances, especially with grand scene changes so the audience can ooh and aw. So as you rapidly approach your first set design project, one of the things that you're going to have to ask yourself as you are reading through your selected script is, what type of stage is going to best tell the story that I want to tell? Does your play have multiple locations? Does the play have one central location and many kind of smaller locations? Which type of set is going to get you where you need to go? And then once you kind of have that figured out, you can then figure out how you're going to incorporate those basic elements of design that we talked about in the previous video.